Hi, I'm Peter Jives, a Jesuit priest and director of A Faith That Does Justice. This Sunday is the fourth Sunday in our Easter season, and we hear the reading from John's Gospel of the Good Shepherd, who lays down his life for his sheep. We're called during this Easter season and beyond to really follow the Good Shepherd, this Jesus of history who leads us to the Christ of faith. And our faith in Jesus becomes verifiable when we live as he lived, and that means taking on the values he lived by, living his love, compassion, and a sense of justice for all God's people. It means also walking into situations as he did of social injustice where there's human suffering, and there to act against human sinfulness, to speak truth to power, and to offer the gifts of our lives so that all people might know life in its fullness as God intends for them. In our first reading, we hear the courage of Easter that's overtaken Peter as he speaks to the Jewish Sanhedrin, the ruling powers of the Jewish society of first century Palestine. And in that, Peter tells the Jewish people that this Jesus has been crucified, but God has raised him from the dead. And he now serves as the cornerstone upon which God's salvific offer to all of humanity will be built. And in our gospel reading, the allegorical story of the Good Shepherd really is something to learn from. The wolf really represents the evil, the human sinfulness that will overtake Jesus' life and kill him. And yet God will raise him from the dead. The hired hand is someone who will really flee at the sight of danger, out of self-interest, and really has no great concern for the sheep entrusted to his care. On the other hand, the Good Shepherd is someone who will lay down his life so that God's offer of salvation, that life in its fullness, can be experienced by all God's people. And so today, during this Easter season and beyond, we're really challenged to really live our faith beyond an intellectual assent to one that really takes on Jesus' way of living in this world. It's countercultural. It's bound to get us in some sense of trouble because society is like the hired hand. It oftentimes seeks self-interest. And we're being asked to live out of self-service on behalf of God's people so that all might know the goodness, might know the potential that God desires for them. And so during this time of Easter season, it's an opportunity for us to step back and to really think about our commitment, one that really ought to move us beyond an intellectual assent to faith, to one that is lived in action. And the way this happens is really through an experience of God's infinite love. God's love will move us beyond ourselves and into the world in which we live. And there we will see human suffering, and there we will be challenged to act as Jesus acted. And it is in our following Jesus and acting as he acted that we will discover the risen Christ of faith and our way of access into this kingdom of God one day, where we will experience the fullness of God's love for all eternity. So it is something to step back, think about this week. I hope that there's time for all of us to do that. I look forward to continuing to speak, and I look forward to speaking with you next week. So be well, be safe, and see you soon.